गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द टॉपिक फ्री फॉल। नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फ्री फॉल, लेट अस डिस्कस दिस। एवरी बॉडी ऑन अर्थ इज अट्रैक्टेड बाय अर्थ टुवर्ड्स इट्स सेंटर, देयरफॉर एवरी ऑब्जेक्ट व्हेन फ्री फॉल्स टुवर्ड्स द अर्थ ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ द अर्थ, ऑल द ऑब्जेक्ट्स फॉलिंग टुवर्ड्स अर्थ अंडर द एक्शन ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स of earth alone, that means there is no other force acting on the object, it is only falling towards the earth under the gravitational force of the earth alone are said to be in free fall. Now let us examine what happens to one free fall. While falling body freely, there is absolutely no change in the direction. If I drop this pen, it falls freely and there is no change in the direction. But due to the constant gravitational force of the earth, the magnitude of the velocity of the falling object goes on increasing. So when if I drop it from here, its velocity after 1 second will become 9.8, after 2 seconds it becomes 19.6, so it goes on increasing. So due to constant gravitational force of the earth, the magnitude of the velocity of falling object goes on increasing. It means acceleration is produced in the body in the free fall, and this acceleration, since it is due to gravity, that is also, therefore it is also known as acceleration due to gravity, and it is denoted by small g. So the acceleration due to gravity on the acceleration produced in a body in a free fall due to the gravitational force of the earth. Now let us see the relation between small g and capital G, that means the acceleration due to gravity and the universal gravitational constant. Now let us see the relation between small g and the capital G, that means the acceleration due to gravity or and universal gravitational constant. Now first let's consider an object of mass m. This is an object of mass m lying on the surface of the earth, and the mass held at a distance of r from center of the earth. Now this distance, that is the radius of the earth, that is noted by r, and the mass of the earth, let the mass of the earth be capital M, denoted by capital M. Now according to universal law of gravitation that was given by Newton, F is equals to, that is the gravitational force of the earth is equal to capital G M M upon R square, where F is the gravitational force, G, capital G is universal gravitational constant, capital M is mass of the earth, small m is mass of the object, and R square is the radius of the earth. So that is given by the universal law of gravitation, that is we have taken the equation number 1. Now according to the Newton's second law of motion, we know that the force is equal to product of mass and acceleration. So according to Newton's second law of motion, F, we know that F is equals to ma, but here the acceleration is due to gravity, so therefore we will be writing F is equals to mg, where g is the acceleration due to gravity. Now from first and second equation, equation number 7, from first equation and second, that is F is same in both, so mg will be equals to capital G m m upon r square. So this m will cancel from both the side. So small g, that is the acceleration due to gravity, will be equals to gm upon r square. So the relation between the acceleration due to gravity and the universal gravitational constant is g, that is small g, is equals to capital G m upon r square, where small g is acceleration due to gravity, this is universal gravitational constant, and is mass of the earth, and r is radius of the earth. Now let us calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity. Now we know, we have just seen that the acceleration due to gravity is given by capital G m upon r square, where this capital G is universal gravitational constant, m is mass of the earth and r is the radius of the earth. Now the value of the acceleration due to gravity will calculate by using this formula, where capital G is 6.7 into 10 raised to minus 11 newton meter square per kg square. So now we put the value here. The value of capital G is 6.7 into 10 raised to minus 11 into mass of the earth, 6 into 10 raised to 24 kg upon radius of the earth, 6.4 into 10 raised to 6, this is square. Now let us solve this. G is equals to 6.7 into 6, that is 40.2 into 10 raised to minus 11 plus 24, we'll add the power here, divided by 6. The square of 6.4 is 40.96, this is 40.96 into, and the square of 10 raised to 6 is 10 raised to 12. Now G is equals to 40.2 divided by 40.96, that will be equals to 0.98 into, this is, when we solve this, this will become 13, and this is 10 raised to 12, that will become minus 12 here. So 13 minus 12 will become 1, so 10 raised to 1 is 10. 10 into 0.98, that will multiply, we will get the 9.8, and the, as you know, the unit of acceleration is meter per second square, so this is also a kind of acceleration, since it is due to gravity, that is why it is acceleration due to gravity, and the unit will become meter per second square. So the value of the acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square.